Hey, everyone, Regroove. Today, quick video. I'm going to talk about email security settings, in particular anti-spam, anti-phishing, and anti-malware policies, where you can find them in your tenancy, and what default protection you have in your organization. So, first, let's define them. Anti-spam policies are policies that help filter out spam emails from your user inboxes. Second, anti-malware policies help protect your organization's email from malware. And then lastly, anti-phishing policies are safety settings and protections against phishing attacks. Where to find them? So first, you would need to have security admin permission to be able to edit these settings. And once you have those, you can find them, or they live at the Microsoft 365 Admin Center under security. So to your admin portal, 365 Admin Center. Then don't worry if you can't find security, you just press show all. And then you go find security here. And then once you're in security and compliance, you're going to go to email and collaboration. And under email and collaboration, you go to policies and rules. And then under policies and rules, all of these policies live in threat policies. So once you're in this site, you'll see there are template policies you can configure. Policies are here, anti-phishing, anti-spam, anti-malware. You can also edit safe attachments, safe links, rules, and others. So let's talk about anti-phishing. So if you go to that option there, as you can see, it's on default Office 365 anti-phish default policy. You can configure this by pressing that option there, and you can edit protection settings here. Don't forget to press save once you reconfigure the settings. You can also edit actions on over here. So actions like if there are messages detected as user impersonation, you can apply actions. Press save. And you can also edit, actions on there. And then close. So let's go to anti-spam. So if you go choose anti-spam, there are three policies that you can configure. Anti-spam inbound connection filter policy and anti-spam outbound policy. So for inbound policies, you can edit the description, you can edit your protection settings here, threshold and properties. So you can edit threshold properties, and you can also do a test mode, and you can edit actions on. So edit actions regarding quarantine policy, well, complaint level, 0 hour auto purge. And then lastly, I believe you can edit trusted senders and domains. Let's see. Yeah, here. Edit allowed and lock senders and domains. So you can edit those here. Senders, domains that are allowed. And then you can also edit the ones that are blocked. Second policy under anti-spam, you can edit connection filter policy. And then last, you can edit outbound policies. So protection settings, and then the configuration is here. And third threat policy that we're going to be talking about are anti-malware policies. So yeah, it's on default right now. You can edit description and protection settings. So to recap, in this video, basically, I talked about email security settings, in particular anti-spam, anti-malware and anti-phishing policies, where to find them, and what default configurations that you have in your tenancy. It's important to note that Microsoft sets these policies and defaults in order when your tenancy is created, but we recommend reviewing these settings often to ensure that your users are best protected in their email communications. And also, while these settings help protect your end user emails, we highly, highly recommend MFA or multi-factor authorization, as it has been proven to stop up to 99% of all incoming attacks. So yeah, that's it. Quick and easy. If you like this video, like and subscribe. Again, Ed from Regroove.